live from Veterans Stadium in Philadelphia. It's the Jacksonville Bulls against the Philadelphia Stars. Philadelphia sporting the best record in the league right now. They have lost only one time, and they lead the team that beat them, the New Jersey Generals, by two full games. Hello again, everybody, and welcome to what we think will be an exciting evening of pro football here at Veterans Stadium in Philadelphia. My name is Mike Barry, pinch hitting for Jim Simpson tonight. You're going to see a treat tonight. First time this year on ESPN, the Stars going for a league record 10th straight victory. Let's call in my old friend, the old quarterback, Don Heinrich. Don, to take nothing away from Philadelphia's offense, I think the key to their success really has been the defense, and yet they are hurting in some key places.
Well, Jim Mora, a defensive specialist, is the architect of this football team. As a head coach, he's been extremely successful. He says experience and depth have been the major factors. Well, he's going to be without two starters, Pete Kugler and William Fuller, but he still has the inspirational, yet maybe a little diminutive, Sam Mills, the inside linebacker who was all pro. At 5'9", he makes his presence felt, and he is very big on that field.
That he does, Don. Bulls coach Lindy Infante told us yesterday, hey, we can win this game even though there are a couple of touchdown underdogs. They're looking for the upset, and for them to pull it off, they're going to need just a superb game from their quarterback, Matt Robinson, and I think the kid's capable of it.
Well, Matt Robinson is obviously the trigger man for Lindy Infante, who believes in living by the pass. Now, tonight, it's going to be a case of whether or not they can handle the blitzing and the heavy rush of the Philadelphia Stars. The quick rhythm passing, whether they can control it, he can read it, and get rid of it successfully is what it's all about.
Should be a good one. We're looking forward to pro football tonight. The Bulls and the Stars. Who knows on any given Saturday night, right? That's it from here for now. Let's go to Tom Mees in our studio.
Thank you very much, Mike Barry. You should have a great crowd tonight in Philadelphia. Good weather. You know, the Jacksonville Bulls committed the game. Two touchdown underdogs. They're going to have to play their best game ever to even stay in it. They have injured linebackers. Tom Dinkle is out. So is Andy Hendel, two starting linebackers. The Stars will be trying to win their 10th game in a row, a new USFL record for one season. Stadium in Philadelphia as the 11-1 Philly Stars host the 4-8 Jacksonville Bulls. The Philadelphia Stars had the best regular season record in the USFL last year. They've only lost one game in the history of the ball club at Veterans Stadium in Philadelphia. They are 11-1 this year. We spoke with head coach Jim Mora of the Stars just a few moments ago and asked him how he does it.
We've got a number of players back from last year's team, which was a pretty good team, and we've been relatively free of injuries, and our quarterback, Chuck Fusina, who went through 20 games with us last year, has had an excellent year, and our defense has been consistent, and these are the main reasons.
Well, I really believe we have to sustain our momentum. Playoffs are coming soon, and we hope to be in them. Right now, we're in a close division race in New Jersey, and we have to play our best ball, especially against Jacksonville tonight, so we can't afford any letdowns at all.
We still kind of hang our hat on a passing game. We got to hope that we get a hot hand throwing the football and have some receivers that can work themselves open. They play a lot of zone defense. We're going to have to try to work the seams in the zone. If we can protect the quarterback and Matt can get a hot hand, we can be competitive.
The beleaguered head coach of the Jacksonville Bulls, Lindy Infante. By the way, Matt Robinson will start, but if he falters early, it'll be Robbie Mahfouz coming in off the bench for the Jacksonville Bulls. With that, let's look at some key players for both sides tonight. First of all, for the visitors, the Jacksonville Bulls, the quarterback I mentioned just a moment ago, number 17, Matt Robinson, in his seventh year from Georgia, missed seven games this year with an ankle injury sustained on this play earlier in the season against the Tampa Bay Bandits. He will be backed up by Robbie Mahfouz. Matt Robinson, though, will be the starter tonight. Watch out for running back Larry Mason, second year from Troy State, had a 45-yard touchdown run last week in Birmingham. And Rush Brown, number 69, he's the new nose tackle, replacing the just-released Don Latimer. For the homestanding Philadelphia Stars, an outstanding 11-1 record, their quarterback from Penn State, Chuck Fusina, his sixth year in the pros, top-rated passer in the USFL. He has 24 touchdown passes, only 7 interceptions in 12 games, and is completing an amazing percentage of 64%. He's got great receivers to throw to. Chuck Fusina having a great year. Kelvin Bryant, the second-year running back for North Carolina, third leading rusher in the league, despite the fact he's missed three games. And linebacker Sam Mills, second year from Montclair State of New Jersey, one of the leading tacklers on defense, and he really is what the Philadelphia Doghouse defense is all about. Philadelphia heavily favored. Let's see if they can live up to the billing. Let's go to Vet Stadium. Mike Barry and Don Heinrich.
We are back live at Veterans Stadium, the city of brotherly love, but there will be no love lost between these two teams here tonight. Jacksonville playing by pride, Philadelphia on a 9-game roll. The earlier rains have cleared out. It is muggy, but it is warm. 66% the humidity, the temperature 74. Could take the toll before the night is over. Bulls coach Lindy Infante, repairing key injuries, plugging holes. He feels he can win this thing if his team does not hand it to Philadelphia on mistakes alone. He's going to need a good ball game. On the other side of the field, Jim Mora, Stars coach, has the odds in his favor. The Stars have not lost here at the Vet since last season, and they will need a solid victory to erase memories of last week's squeaker with Los Angeles. They won that ball game by a score of 18-14, but for the first time all year long, they had to come from behind in that ball game, aside from the game against Arizona, another one where they came from behind. But Jim Mora really wants to do something good here tonight. They're looking for a crowd somewhere in the neighborhood of about 30,000 here at the Vet. Brian Franco will tee it up for Jacksonville. Philadelphia to our left in the crimson and gold. They will be back to receive here, and they will put the ball in play, their first possession. Mark McCants, number 20, will be deep to receive for Philadelphia. Brian Franco out there right now. As we said, they're looking for a crowd right now. Matt Robinson thinking things over in his mind. The young man out of Georgia, the six-year pro. He'll need a big game if they're going to pull off the upset tonight, because the Stars are heavily favored here in their home ballpark. These guys haven't lost here since last season. We're just about set for football. Number 20, Mark McCants, the deep man, standing in his own end zone for the Philadelphia Stars. And Brian Franco, a little guy who really likes to boom his kicks, will be booting it off, teeing it up right now for the Jacksonville Bulls. A good night for football here on ESPN on Saturday night. My name's Mike Barry, Don Heinrich alongside. We look for a good one. As we said in the pregame show, who knows, on any given Saturday night, because there's no hiding the fact that Philadelphia is always tough at home, only one loss over two seasons here in the United States Football League. We are underway. McCants at his own goal line. Across the 10, goes to the far side, scoots his way up past the 30, and this guy is on his way, tripped up at the 40-yard line, finally brought down at the 45 by number 23, Donald Dykes. Here comes Chuck Fusina for the Philadelphia Stars. He's the quarterback out of Penn State. His receivers will be Willie Collier and Scott Fitzke. The tight end is Steve Folsom. In the backfield, Davld Riley and Kelvin Bryant. They'll work behind a line of Brad Oates, George Gilbert, Bart Oates, Chuck Comiskey, and Irv Eatman. Fusina ready for the first snap of the ball game. Collier wide to the top of your screen. Fitzke in the slot. Fitzke in motion to the near side now. Action fake to Riley, and Fusina puts the ball in the air on the first play, and it's complete down to the 41-yard line of Jacksonville to Willie Collier, his 39th catch of the year. In on the stop for Jacksonville, number 46, Don Besseldew. The defense for Jacksonville, they'll play a 3-4. Up front, you've got Bob Clasby, Rush Brown, and Joe Costello.
Chuck Fusina has been throwing the football a lot more on first down this season than he did a year ago, Mike, and of course, as Jim Moore said before the game, talking with him, that while his offense and defenses are playing well, his special teams have been very successful. They got him excellent field position with Fusina coming out the first play of the game with a completion.
Second down now, Collier to the top of your screen. Donovan to the near side. Pro set in the backfield. Play action fake to Bryant. Fusina, plenty of time, rolls to the near side, puts it up. He's got Fitzke down near the 24-yard line. Scott Fitzke, the former Philadelphia Eagle, the kid out of Penn State, with a big catch here as the Philadelphia Stars are moving it on this, their first possession, Don.
Little play action fake. They utilize a lot of sweeps as Kelvin Bryant comes across. Bryant drifted into the flat. He wanted the football. You see him right there, but on the other hand, Fusina, recognizing Fitzke had the bigger gain, laid it in, got him in close.
First and 10, they'll mark the ball inside the 25-yard line. No score, we are just underway. Philadelphia taking the opening kickoff and are driving now. There goes Bryant sweeping left. Nice juke step inside, cuts his way down near the 15, inside the 15-yard line, before he is tripped up by the safety, Sammy Brown. Brown, a rookie out of Georgia Tech.
And what a great move as he started that sweep. The right guard pulling there is Chuck Comiskey, 290 pounds as he puts out the lights. And coming in, 46, is Don Besselou before Kelvin Bryant says, just a minute, I'm cutting back on you. Picks up some extra yards. One of the sweeps that has not worked successfully early in this season, starting out well tonight.
Normally, Philadelphia is a right-handed team. They will run to the right side behind Comiskey and Eatman. That time, Comiskey pulling and going to the left side. Another first down for the Stars. You've seen another play action. Puts the ball in the air, and look at this. Touchdown to number 81, Scott Fitzke. Nobody was near him, beating his man badly on the play, and the Philadelphia Stars, wasting no time at 12:05 and missed the first quarter of action, are on the football board. They lead by a score of 6-0. The man that Fusina beat on the play, the linebacker Greg Zapala, with a nifty move by Scott Fitzke, winding his way into the near corner of the end zone.
Well, Fusina on the quick play fake, you see 57 coming into his face right there. That's Zapala. In the meantime, Fitzke ran a post-corner move, kind of lulled number 22, Kevin Gray, and put it in the end zone for 6 points.
13-yard scoring pass on the first down, as you say, Fusina putting it up. Trout with the extra point, and it's good. So with 12:05 here to play in the first quarter, the Philadelphia Stars wasting no time drawing first. David Trout to kick off for Philadelphia. Aubrey Matthews, the fastest man on Jacksonville team, takes it at his own goal line, and boom, he's hit at the 14-yard line. Big play by Philadelphia special teams there. Number 82, Victor Harrison, on the special teams with a big play. Matt Robinson to put the ball in play now. He'll take the first snap from center at his own 15-yard line. Jacksonville, Robinson in the backfield, Larry Mason and Marvin Lewis. The wide receivers, Alton Alexis and Gary Clark. The tight end is Paul Bergman. The line of Gruber, Howell, Oti, Collins, and Hudson. Jacksonville, first and 10 from their own 15-yard line. They like to put the ball in the air. On the first play from scrimmage, though, the ball goes to number 32. That is Larry Mason. Mason fights his way for about 3. That'll make it second down at about 8. Mike Lushian on the stop for the Philadelphia Stars defense will be calling his name a lot tonight. They also play a 3-4, Philadelphia does. Buddy Moore, Dave Ofer, and Don Fielder, the down linemen. The backers, Bunting, Howard, Mills, and Cooper. The corners, Garcia Lane and Jonathan Sutton. And the safeties, Antonio Gibson and Mike Lush. Second and 7, ball resting on the 18-yard line. Perry Kemp goes wide to the far side. Gary Clark wide to the near side. Robinson over the middle, looking for his big tight end, number 88, Robert Young, out of Bethune-Cookman College. Don, there is a school that has given us guys like Larry Little and Isaac Curtis, old Bethune-Cookman.
Well, it was a time when not too many football players came out of that area, but certainly they do now. The scouts don't miss them. Lindy Infante changing up. He's reaching back to when they beat Oklahoma some weeks ago, going with a two tight end offense with Bergman and Young at those tight ends to give him a little bit more firepower in the running game.
Marvin Lewis and Larry Mason are the backs. Wide to the top of your screen is Clark. There you see the pulling guard, and Mason fights his way across the 30, up near the 31-yard line before he is gang tackled by the Philadelphia Stars and their swarming defense. Don Fielder, the right defensive end. This guy has 4 quarterback sacks on the year. He making the initial hit, along with linebacker Glenn Howard out of Minnesota.
One thing, Jim Moore, as we mentioned in the open, he emphasizes defense. And his clubs, wherever he's involved coaching, have been very successful. They are a swarming defense. That was a typical example. Great pursuit.
Alton Alexis goes wide to the top of your screen. Gary Clark comes to the near side. They work from the pro set. Robinson from his own 31. The quick shot here in the near flat, intended on the play for number 80, Gary Clark, out of James Madison. Defending on the play, Garcia Lane for Philadelphia. And boy, Garcia Lane was the guy that brought them the win last week down against Los Angeles.
Well, he was. He intercepted a ball, returned at 46 yards down to the 2-yard line of L.A. when they were trailing 14-9. So he made a big play. Right there, he was beat. Gary Clark should have caught that football. Robinson with the play action had to get rid of it quick. It was there.
Alexis in the ball game now. So is Perry Kemp. On a 3rd and 9 for Jacksonville. Robinson to go to the air again. Over the middle.
complete to number 80, Gary Clark. Clark, with a couple of catches already, came into the ballgame as the leading receiver on this Bulls offense. In on the hit, number 23, Antonio Gibson, one of the finest athletes on Philadelphia's defense.
Good protection up front. They got a little twist going on, but good line of vision for Matt Robinson as Clark ran a square in type of move, took it about 15 yards and broke it to the inside right in the center of the zone. And this is the key right here. Protection for Robinson in order to put points on the board.
Nice block in there by the left tackle, Bob Gruber. First down now. They give to Mason, tries to sweep right, gets himself up near the 40-yard line, just shy of there. Sam Mills, number 54, along with Glenn Howard, number 51. The linebackers in on the stop for Philadelphia. You alluded, Don, in the pregame to Sam Mills, number 54, a kid who was only 5'9", but has a heart as big as all outdoors.
He really does, but he's also 225 pounds, so that makes up maybe for he got shortened up because he was backing up that line. He took too many hits in the head. He probably started at 6'4".
Larry Mason said, they never taught me back in Troy State how to run past a bowling ball, and that is Sam Mills. Second and four. Ball on the 41-yard line of Philadelphia. A flag is down on the play as Mason tries to sweep right and is dragged down from behind by number 91, Buddy Moore, out of Eastern Kentucky. Buddy Moore making his first stop.
Looks like an illegal procedure against the Jacksonville Bulls. They've been moving the ball pretty well here early since they got scored on, but that's going to be important to sustain some momentum. And now they get backed up with
illegal formation. The right guard and right tackle not on the line of scrimmage. The penalty is declined. Third down.
As I was about to say, Mike, to sustain that momentum is going to be important for them, with Philadelphia refusing this penalty. It keeps it at third and about six.
Oakland has jumped on top of Memphis 7-0 at 9:07 to play in the first quarter. Newton on a one-yard run, capping a 64-yard drive. Our score here, Philadelphia leading Jacksonville 7-0. Third and six for the Bulls. The Stars in the nickel defense, because they know Matt Robinson's going to the air. They live and die by the pass. So far, they've been moving it, missed their first drive. The pass a little bit thrown behind, number 80, Gary Clark. So that'll bring up a kicking situation. Garcia Lane in on that hit. There you see him, number 47. We'll be calling his name a lot. The kid out of Ohio State. Five interceptions on the year for Garcia Lane. And as we say, the key interception last week that brought them to a come-from-behind win over the Los Angeles Express. Garcia Lane will be back now to receive. Jeff Pierce, number 8, the kicker for Jacksonville. Garcia Lane. He's broken one for 27 yards so far this year. The ball is in the air to the near corner. Lane lets it sail over his head, and it goes out of bounds down near the 12-yard line. So the Philadelphia Stars on their second possession will take the ball first and 10 at the 12-yard line. And we'll be back with more action. Back live at the Vet in Philadelphia, where the Stars are enjoying a 7-0 lead with 8:16 to play here in the first quarter. Philadelphia now with their second possession on the night will put the ball in play, first and 10 from their own 17-yard line. Chuck Fusina, good close-up shot there by our ESPN crew here from Philadelphia. And the pitch back to Kelvin Bryant. Tripped up near the 18, probably to the 19-yard line. Number 22, the cornerback for Jacksonville, Kevin Gray, out of Eastern Illinois, in on the stop. Kelvin Bryant was injured earlier in the year, but he's back in there and probably as healthy as he's been, Don.
Yes, he missed three games with orthoscopic surgery. They did not expect him to get back as quickly as he did, but Jim Moore says he's probably as healthy as he's been in 2 years.
It's easier to come back from that lately than it is to pronounce it. I know exactly what you mean. Second down now for Fusina and the Stars. 19-yard line. Play action fake. Fusina with plenty of time. Goes to his outlet man, Bryant, overthrows him. The pass incomplete, bringing up a third down situation, and there is a flag down back near Fusina.
I believe they got a roughing the passer call coming up. I think possibly Bob Clasby, the defensive end, is guilty of hitting Fusina just as he was trying to dump it off to the backside over there to Kelvin Bryant.
The nose tackle, number 69 for Jacksonville, Rush Brown, out of Ball State, also in on that play.
Personal foul, unnecessary roughness against the quarterback, number 99 on the defense. First down.
Joe Costello picked up the wrong number there. The two defensive ends, Clasby and Costello. Costello, their best pass rusher.
Three down linemen. We mentioned two of them, and it was Costello.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. Chuck Fusina knows who it is. He said, get that truck's number.
First down now for the Stars. The ball resting just shy of the 35-yard line. Two backs. Collier, the wide receiver, to the top of your screen. Fitzke in the slot, and Bryant gets the call across the 40 and spins his way up near the 43-yard line before he is brought down by Greg Zappella. Take a look at the pulling right guard, Chuck Comiskey and George Gilbert.
Big number 69 coming out in front as he did to the left side down near the goal line, led it. Here he comes to the right side this time. Behind him is George Gilbert, 63, but he throws that block out there on Kevin Gray in order to spring Kelvin Bryant.
The big offensive line and talented for Philadelphia, Brad Oates, George Gilbert, Bart Oates, Chuck Comiskey, and Irv Eichmann. It's BYU, Tulsa, BYU, Mississippi, and UCLA up front leading the way. A lot of protection this time, and it's complete to number 86, Willie Collier, and he steps his way, dancing down the sidelines and out of bounds near the 37-yard line of Jacksonville.
Oh, and a nice throw by Chuck Fusina. You'll see again the play-action fake, and when you run the ball as much as they do, that keeps that secondary up in there to where they have trouble reading pass against run, as we ran into a little bit of a technical problem there, but Fusina really rifled that ball out there to Willie Collier, picks up his 40th reception of the season on a little sideline move.
Willie Collier, now the leading receiver. He and the tight end Steve Folsom came into the ballgame tied, each with 38 catches. Fusina's going to make it a night all night for those fellas. Alan Harvin in the ballgame sweeps to the far side, around the left side, gets his way across the 35, down near the 34-yard line. Sammy Brown from Georgia Tech, the safety for Jacksonville, in on the hit. Alan Harbin
had an excellent year a year ago. This year has not been quite as productive. He's got excellent quickness, good speed, but he's been hampered a little bit with injuries as he's coming out of the football game.
He's had three games already this year where he has out-dueled Kelvin Bryant. Of course, Bryant, the MVP in the USFL last season, the kid out of North Carolina. They bank a lot of their offensive attack around him. And when he was out, Fusina said, let me put the ball in the air more. That's what he's been doing. This time, the kid goes to Bryant. He's got nowhere to go. John McLean, number 50, out of Florida State, says, hey, we're going to close the door right here on you, Mr. Bryant.
Well, John McLean getting his first start tonight as an injury to Andy Hendel, their outstanding young rookie linebacker. Bryant on the sweep again. See how he gets those hands around the front of that ball to put it away? He wants to reverse his field as McLean, number 50, comes in there. But McLean says, Kelvin, this is as far as you're going this time. I don't want you reversing the field on us.
It's got to be a real morale booster, a confidence booster for McLean, because as you say, those linebackers of Tom Dinkle and Andy Hendel, their starting leaders on defense, are both out this week with injuries. So McLean filling in and making a big play. Third down, 11. Fusina to go to the air. Plenty of time. It's complete to number 86, Willie Collier, down right in front of our cameras. The ball down near the 25-yard line.
Well, it appears as though there was a mix-up in the secondary as they give him that slot look. Collier coming downfield, number 86. Nothing fancy, just pushes off number 47, Sammy Brown, the strong safety. Tries to roll for a little bit. He could get up and run, conceivably, but he sees Matt Courtney coming in to pin him down at that stage. So using a little discretion, he stayed there.
Tommy Donovan in the ballgame goes wide to the far side. Fitzke in the slot up there. The backs, Kelvin Bryant and David Riley. First down from the 25. That's Bryant. Inside the 20. The big horse has a lot of room. Down near the 15-yard line. He pulls his way down there. Some good moves down near another first down for Fernando Jackson out of Florida, the linebacker for Jacksonville, went on the stop.
Well, you mentioned the good moves. In front of a 35, Davld Riley on just a lead type of a play. Bryant dipping to the outside. And the good moves, among other things, include that quickness to accelerate. That's exactly what he did as he bolted through there.
Kelvin Bryant leaves the ball game as Philadelphia goes to the two tight end offense. They are just shy of a first down. Second and less than a yard from the 16-yard line, from the I formation. Play action fake, Fusina. Complete and out of bounds to the tight end Steve Folsom, number 89 from Utah. Folsom's the kind of target that you like, Don. He played basketball at Utah. He's a big guy. 6'4", 230.
Came back bigger and stronger this year. Did a little off-season weight work. Once again, the play action fake. Good quick release by Fusina right there. Just a kind of an out move down the line of scrimmage by Folsom. Once again, Sammy Brown, the strong safety, man for man. Should have had him. Was too far off.
Pretty angle from our camera crew there. Looked like you were in the defensive backfield for Jacksonville. First and 10, the ball resting on the 13. Pitsky in motion to the near side. From the eye, the pitch back to Bryant. Harvin, and he is out of bounds down near the 5-yard line. Alan Harvin, the 5'10", 209-pound second-year man out of Cincinnati, giving Kelvin Bryant a breather here.
One thing Harvin has, too, in addition to that speed and quickness, great balance. He can go in there and get knocked sideways because of that compact stature, stay on his feet in pretty good fashion. He's the only guy in this ball club, Mike, that has gained over 100 yards. That was a year ago, next to Kelvin Bryant, who has done it 11 times.
Jeff Rodenberger is now in the ballgame. Number 34, along with Alan Harvin. The gift of Davld Riley, and Riley is into the end zone for a touchdown. Davld Riley, the man who is normally called on to block, follows behind the big right end and the right tackle and the right guard, Chuck Comiskey and Irby, and they clear the way, and Davld Riley, number 35, is in there. They've got an unusual spike, the Philadelphia Stars. That's called the Duck Shuffle. And boy, I don't know where they came up with that name, but anytime Jim Morris sees it, he's happy because he knows they've scored.
Exactly, and Riley coming off that right side. Good blocking up front. You saw everybody down on the ground as Riley just lowers that shoulder and goes rolling up into that end zone. You see the guard pulling around, but you see people on the ground. That's the key right there.
Tim Reardon will do the holding. The kick by Davld Riley is up. It's right through the uprights, and we suddenly have a 14-0 ball game. A flag down on the play, but the extra point will count. Our score with 3:36 left to play. Lots more action. Don't go anywhere. 14-0 at 3:36 left to play here in the first quarter, and Don, Jacksonville has got to do something before this turns into a rout.
Well, they certainly do, and Philadelphia really coming out of the chute fast. Jim Moore concerned that their club might be a little complacent. You know, players will talk about playing hard. They might not do it. He said they had a good week of practice and that they were ready, and they certainly looked it.
Davld Trout, a little guy with a big heart and a big leg, booms this one almost out of the end zone. Aubrey Matthews takes it deep in his own zone and downs it. So the Jacksonville Bulls, wearing the white uniforms with the maroon pants, will put the ball in play first and 10 from their own 20-yard line.
Nice drive, 10 plays, 83 yards, almost 5 minutes to take it down the field when they started backed up in their own territory, but a great mixture of plays. They keeping the Bulls off balance on defense as they had very effective running game and then a lot of first down passing.
Well, what you've got here, Don, of course, is an expansion team in Jacksonville against a team that was in the championship game a year ago, the second year team, the Philadelphia Stars, and they don't make many mistakes. Robinson on first down puts the ball in the air, and it's complete to number 80, Gary Clark, the kid out of James Madison. The ball down across the 30 near the 34-yard line.
Well, Matt Robinson, just a very short drop, and that's what they're going to have to do. It's a five-step drop as he gives a little draw fake. So that he can get rid of it, keep that pressure off of him. He lets the ball go before Gary Clark had turned. Clark going downfield about 12 yards or so and then just hooking up to the inside in the open area.
Robbie Mafu is standing on the sideline. He's the backup quarterback. He's seen a lot of action because Matt Robinson was out for 6 weeks with a sprained foot. This is his second time back, and he's trying to regain the form that saw him one of the passing leaders early in the season. Puts the ball in the air, and again he's got Gary Clark up near the 50-yard line. Looks like Philadelphia's given him a little room there in the secondary.
Well, I'm sure that the six-year veteran, Matt Robinson, going to Gary Clark here, he knows he's working on Garcia Lane, the rookie. That's 54, getting the pass drop back there. Not quite deep enough, Sam Mills, but really the open area is driving Garcia Lane off and letting Clark get that intermediate pass.
Two plays, both to Gary Clark, two first downs. The ball resting on the 50 right now. They're going to run this one. This is Larry Mason out of Troy State, and he gets nowhere. As the swarming defense, number 56, George Cooper, with a big tackle there for Philadelphia. Some other action around the USFL this Saturday night. Out at Oakland, around the Bay Area. The Invaders are leading Memphis 10-0. 43 seconds left to play in the first quarter on a Shea 22-yard field goal. Here, the Stars are laying it on Jacksonville 14-0. But Matt Robinson and the Bulls in the white uniforms to the right of your screen as you look from our end zone overhead camera are trying to mount a drive. They are inside Philadelphia territory as Robinson puts it up, intended for Gary Clark, but right on him was Garcia Lane, number 47, and you don't want to get the ball too close to him. A flag is down back inside the 50-yard line.
Usually indicative of a holding penalty where it's thrown by the umpire. Matt Robinson under heavy pressure, went a little deeper that time, took a couple of licks just as he let go of the ball. Trying to get those quick rhythm passes going for him. He had a couple in a row successful, and then this time, and it looks as though the officials are marking it off against Philadelphia.
Number 96 on the defense, still second down.
Well, it was roughing the passer. I said a couple of licks. Don Fielder, the defensive end, gave him a little extra touch there, so it cost him.
The referee for tonight's ball game, whose name you hear marking out those calls, is Tom White. The other officials, Ed Manning, Robert Walker, Lawrence Hill, William Lang, Gerard Greiser, and Horton Nestra. Second and three at the Philadelphia 47-yard line. From the pro set, Robinson to put it up again. He's going deep. He's looking for Gary Clark. Clark got turned around. Garcia Lane was right on him. The ball in the vicinity, but it looked like he had to change his direction just a little bit and couldn't get down to where the ball was thrown.
The ball a little bit short that time by Matt Robinson. He underthrew it. Gary Clark had him beat by a couple of steps. You can see him out in front there with Garcia Lane as the ball is short. He's trying to adjust to it. There's some bumping around going out there, but the official, at his discretion and his interpretation, no interference call.
The Bulls converting on a little less than 39% of their third downs. Watch the draw play here. 33, the ball on the 43-yard line. Number 85, Perry Kemp in the ball game, goes in motion. The pass drilled right over the middle to number 89, Alton Alexis, and Robinson threaded the needle on that one right on target.
Yes, he did. He put it in between a couple of linebackers. Little problem initially with the formation is Robinson wanted some people and going a different direction, stumbles a little bit going back. 94 bearing down on him is Dave Ofer, the nose tackle, but a well-thrown ball down the middle. Sam Mills, number 54, he's blitzing, gets tripped there by number 56. George Cooper, good job of picking up the blitz.
The Bulls mounting a drive. First down for the Philadelphia 30, Robinson in the air. He threw that one away. Looked like maybe his arm was hit in the backfield as he released the football. Robinson has been getting some good protection from his offensive line. Bob Gruber, Kenny Howell, Dave Odie, George Collins, and Matt Hudson, the beef up front. Fellas out of Pitt, Georgia Tech, UCLA, Georgia, and Georgia.
Well, the Stars will generally line up in that three-man front. Sometimes they will come with four when they go to the nickel. But they have so many combinations of blitzes, always bringing at least one linebacker, sometimes two, sometimes the safeties.
Second and 10, ball on the 30-yard line. Lone setback. They're going to send out some receivers on this play. Whoa, look at this. The handoff goes to Larry Mason on the decoy. Mason out of Troy State. Six touchdowns on the year. Bangs into Glenn Howard, the linebacker, number 51.
You know, one thing effective, they tried the draw right there. You feel that when you're putting the ball in the air and you're getting a lot of blitzing like the Stars will do, if you can get through that initial defensive unit, the line and linebackers, you got plenty of running room. But Jim Mora's teams, always so well drilled, somebody is responsible for every player out there, and they were sitting in on that one.
There's the gun signaling the end of the first quarter of action. The Philadelphia Stars are leading Jacksonville 14-0. That is Matt Robinson. He needs a drink. And on the left of your screen, Chuck Fusina enjoying a 2-touchdown lead. Stars in the driver's seat as we get ready to start the second quarter of play. Mike Barry along with Don Heinrich. Jim Simpson has the night off, and it was a big first quarter for Philadelphia.
Stats fairly equal there despite the score on the scoreboard at 14-0 in favor of the Stars.
Now to the left of your screen in the white uniforms, that is the Jacksonville Bulls, and they are driving. Third and eight, the ball resting on the 28, and look at this. The Stars came in there. Number 54, Sam Mills, with the quarterback sack, his fourth sack of the season.
And Sam Mills hitting the gap between the guard and the tackle. You'll see him coming right there. Nobody picks him up. That's 51, Dave Odie, the center, blocking to the left. The right guard, George Collins, handling the man to his right, just leaving that gap. A little confusion, and Sam Mills drops Matt Robinson.
Just when Jacksonville was about to turn this into a closer ball game, a big play for Sam Mills, number 54, the kid out of Little Montclair State.
Takes him out of field goal range.
Jeff Pierce will kick from about his own 45-yard line, standing on the 50 right now. Garcia Lane is back. Pierce angles it out of bounds. Pierce not sure where they're going to mark it, but we'll be here to see where they do.
More blitzing Sam Mills right there to take the Bulls out of potential field goal range and keeps any kind of points off the scoreboard.
I'll tell you about a little subtlety. In the first quarter all year long, Philadelphia has outscored its opponents 65-0. The ball carrier gets plenty of room, and there is a flag thrown on the play. It'll probably be a holding call.
Bryant not happy with it. You mentioned the scoring that they've had in that first quarter. You're absolutely right. That certainly is not any kind of a subtlety to the other teams.
65-0, they have outscored their opponents. That was not all season. That's in the last six games alone. So they're making themselves heard in this football league.
That's what you call taking it to them.
You see the scoring. Philadelphia scored 318 points.
50 on the offense. Replay first down.
Well, we were right about the holding call. Look at this. Memphis has scored. The Showboats. Walter Lewis, a 38-yard run. He scooted in for the touchdown. It's a 10-7 ball game. Oakland still on top.
What an exciting player he is.
First and 20. Philadelphia in the first hole of the night from the I formation. The give is to Bryant, the second man. The tailback in the formation. He spins his way around the far side and is dropped by the cornerback, number 22, Kevin Gray. Brian Douglas also in on the stop, number 78 from Tulane.
Kevin Gray making the initial hit over there. As Bryant put a little bit of a move on him, Kevin Gray is getting plenty of practice for his tackling abilities here early in this football game, as Bryant has chosen to go his way on several occasions. That time he did a pretty good job of it.
They go to the two tight end offense. Steve Folsom and Ken Dunnick are in the ballgame now. Second down and 14. The ball resting on the 15-yard line. The lone setback is Bryant. Fusina, he's being chased. Steps out of the pocket and completes the pass to number 89, Steve Folsom. Vaughn Johnson, number 33, the linebacker from North Carolina State, in on the stop.
Good
the ball
adjustment.
Sitting on the 22 now.
Good adjustment by Fusina right there. Excuse me, Mike. As he got flushed out of the pocket, moving to his left, picked up Folsom downfield and turned in a potential sack. And that's what experience in playing does for a quarterback. The ability to slow the game down. You're able to kind of look things over. You take your time, in a sense, and then find somebody when you're scrambling.
Jacksonville goes to the nickel defense. They've got their speedy guys in the secondary on the third and nine. Fitzke in motion to the near side. Fusina with a deep drop over the middle, intended for Davld Riley, and flags come out all over the field. Vaughn Johnson, number 33, looks like maybe he got caught for something. Take a look at number 33.
Vaughn Johnson, the rookie out of North Carolina State. Little grab right there as he manages to kind of undress Davld Riley just a little bit. Riley earned that job against Arizona, got his first start, scored a couple of touchdowns in that game. Booker Russell was the starter for the first three games of the season. He has lost his position, and Riley has come on to be a real force in that offense. An excellent blocker, good hands, more versatile, and that's exactly why Jim Morris got him in a ball game.
Defensive pass interference, number 33, first down.
Well, that doesn't sit too well with number 33, Vaughn Johnson, or the Bulls coach, Lindy Infante, over there talking to Matt Robinson on the sideline. Tom Donovan in the ballgame now, number 87, along with number 84, Herbert Harris at the wide receiver spots. And it's Bryant, the ball carrier, across the 40, across the 45, spins his way up near the 48-yard line. Don Besalou, the free safety, number 46, in on the stop.
Another little subtlety right there as they pull both guards. The right guard, Comiskey, number 69. The left guard, George Gilbert, number 63. Another flag is down, but Kelvin Bryant had made a counter step to the right. Freezes those linebackers for a moment. Slows down that pursuit, and then he came around the corner. However, they're going to back it up.
Right tackle on the offense, not on the line of scrimmage. Play first down.
They say Irv Eatman, the offensive right tackle. I don't know how you could not be up in the line of scrimmage when you're 2'6", 276 pounds. All you got to do is lean over and you got to be there.
That guy's a neutral zone all by himself.
Huh? Really?
The All-American out of UCLA. Eatman doesn't make too many mistakes.
Well, one of the best in the league, can play anywhere.
First down, 15 yards to go, ball resting on the 32. Alan Harvin in the ballgame now, and he gets the call. Spins his way to the far side, up near the 40-yard line before he is dragged down from behind by number 22, Kevin Gray.
Harvin giving Kelvin Bryant a little breather. Once again, the sweep to the left of the screen, going right. Good job of blocking over there. You see both guards pulling, coming to that right side. Harvin moving along behind Gilbert, 69. Nice little move right there on Gray as he tries to kind of give him a limp leg and move to the outside. Comiskey coming out, 69. You can take a good look what it's like to be a defensive man as he gets a little piece of John McLean, number 50, the linebacker.
Davld Riley and Alan Harvin are in at running backs now. And they help block as Fusina puts it up long. He's going to air it out just out of the outstretched reach of number 81, Scott Fitzke. Those two guys, Fusina and Fitzke, hooked up at Penn State.
The ball just a little overthrown to Fitzke. Not great speed on Fitzke's part, as he's more of a control pass route runner. You could see number 22, Kevin Gray, the corner, trying to get over there to help. He had him pretty well covered. They were in a blitz look that time. Fusina had went to the automatic, and obviously that's what they want to do. They'll take a gamble for the big one, particularly when you're ahead 14 to nothing. The backs picked up all of the blitz. But right now, Fusina says, I don't like what I see over there. A little confusion. Let's take a timeout.
And that's probably the wise thing to do with 12:19 left to play here in the second quarter, leading by a score of 14 to nothing. It is Penn State night here. Mike Barry along with Don Heinrich, 12:19 remaining to play, second quarter. The Philadelphia Stars have had things pretty much their way. They lead in the ball game 14-0. They face a third down and seven, the ball on the 40-yard line. Riley and Harvin are the running backs behind Chuck Fusina. Fusina running for his life. Puts the ball in the air, and it's complete. The number 81, Scott Fitzke. So the Penn State crew finally hooks up. This is Penn State night here at Veterans Stadium. They've got some 2,000 to 3,000 Penn State alumni on hand. And, of course, Fusina and Fitzke, the winning passing combination for Joe Paterno at Penn State during their collegiate days.
I guess you might say that's the Penn State connection with all the fans here. They had some 2,000-plus out in the parking lot earlier.
Well, in honor of that, too, Don, the Philadelphia Stars awarded their first annual Joe Paterno Award to the player from Penn State, best exemplifying the leadership qualities of Mr. Paterno. And that, of course, went to Chuck Fusina, the Stars quarterback before tonight's ballgame. First and 10 from the 46. Fusina to the air. In the middle. Complete to number 84, Herbert Harris out of Lamar. 6'2", 192-pounder, a first-year man, Herbert Harris, in the ballgame. He normally plays on special teams, but he made a nice comeback catch on that one.
Once again, the play-action fake is Fusina faking to the halfback. Throws it right down the middle. They had a double zone to the outside. Wide open as Don Vesalu comes across to make the final touch. Bryant, a nice pickup over there. Looks like he is a little more of the taker rather than the giver in that instance, but it did the job effectively.
Herbert Harris remains in the ballgame. First and 10, the ball resting on the Bulls, 23, and Bryant gets the call and goes to the right side, but he finds nothing but a wall of Jacksonville blockers. Don Vesalu, number 46, leading the charge on that play.
The Stars tonight using a lot more sweeps than they had previously this season. They've been a better tackle-to-tackle team, going straight ahead, trying to blow people out. But they're getting off with a pretty good wide game here this evening, despite the fact that one didn't work very well. As once you get that football, as you well know, Mike, you draw a crowd, and he did.
Second down and 9. To the top of your screen. Fusina to put it up. The short flare pass in the flat to Kelvin Bryant. He does a little dance inside the 20-yard line down to the 18 before he is racked up by Floridian Fernando Jackson.
Fernando Jackson, excellent speed as he comes across on that screen play. But the guy that made it work initially was Brad Oates, number 70, offensive left tackle. He kicked out on the cornerback, Donald Dykes. And then a great read by Kelvin Bryant to recognize it with that tremendous athletic ability. A little quick cutback that turned almost a no-gain play into a nice 5-yarder.
Brad Oates, one of those on the walking wounded list for Philadelphia, missed 5 weeks earlier in the season after knee surgery, but he is back. Riley and Harvin, the running backs, now behind Fusina, who's going to put the ball in the air again, and he hits David Riley for the touchdown. And there is a flag thrown back behind the line of scrimmage near where Fusina released that football. Tom White, the referee, talking to number 70, Brad Oates. And the call will go against the Philadelphia Stars.
And Brad Oates extremely unhappy as he's up there challenging the official. You know he's going to lose, but of course, he is a practicing attorney in the offseason. I think he may have to go back to the law books. He isn't going to win this debate. He's talking to the judge.
I knew you'd get that little fun fact to know and tell in the ballgame.
Well, what a timing.
He is a practicing attorney.
On that particular...
Holding number 70 on the offense. Replay third down.
On that particular play, he was up there trying to negotiate his own deal. But unfortunately, he was going to lose, and then he was still challenging that official. Lucky he didn't get another flag thrown.
He was overruled. At least he was not held in contempt of court. Brad Oates, number 70, the left tackle for the Philadelphia Stars.
8-year veteran, lost his cool just a little bit.
Well, it's tough when you have to score a touchdown.
Absolutely.
And then get it called back.
Oh,
because
really?
Fusina really threw a nice pass. You
yes,
see, Oates
did.
Is still hot.
Yes, he is. He'll go down and talk to his brother, the offensive center.
That's
he's
right.
He's a lot younger. He'll say, listen to me.
George Gilbert, number 63, the left guard. He's got to be having a little tough time concentrating with the Oates brothers talking to each other when they go up to the line.
That was a well-thrown football by Fusina.
David Riley in on the reception, normally a blocking fullback, but they found out this year, Jim Moore did, that he can catch the football, and they've been throwing to him more and more.
Had 18 catches coming into this football game.
Alan Harvin is the lone setback on third and 15. The ball on the 28-yard line. Jacksonville with five defensive backs. Fusina. A little flare pass in the far flat to Alan Harvin, who gets his way inside the 20 down near the 17-yard line before he is dragged to the turf here by Don Besselou, number 46.
What a great move by Alan Harvin out there on that swing. A good reaction by Fusina as he looked upfield. You'll see 33 in the left corner of your screen. That's Johnson, Vaughn Johnson. Fusina, you see, look upfield. He sees nothing, fires it out to Harvin, and then with that hesitation move, Johnson slips, goes to the ground. Harvin picks up extra yards, and once again on fourth down, it looks as though the Stars are threatening with a three-point attempt.
David Trout will attempt a 34-yard field goal. There's the boot. And it's good. So the Philadelphia Stars, having the touchdown pass to David Riley called back, settle for three, but they're still in the driver's seat, 17-0.
See Aubrey Matthews moving over there to get the football. Just really doesn't, you know, you think for a receiver you got to have pretty good hands, which he does, but he just misjudges it a little, and you got to question, should you field it? The ball not coming down in a typical end over end fashion makes it a little difficult to handle, but still no reason not to. And then as he goes for it, going out of bounds, stumbling, fumbling, and finally falling and putting the Bulls in trouble.
Matt Robinson will work from his own end zone. First and 10, the ball on the 2-yard line. Alton Alexis comes wide to the near side. The handoff right up the middle to Larry Mason, and he gets nothing. Oh, maybe a yard.
He took a hit in there.
Rich Dimmler in on the stop.
11 plays, 62 yards, and they used a lot of time with it to score that time with the field goal. 6 minutes with Trout's 34-yarder. And now the Bulls, in their own territory, you would expect they don't have a particularly effective running game, are going to have to put it in the air to give them some operating room.
The ball still resting on the 2-yard line, second down and 10. The handoff again goes to Larry Mason. This time he goes off left tackle before he is stopped by Glenn Howard up near the 5-yard line. So they give Robinson a little breathing room, but still, he'll have to go to the air again on third down. As you take a look at Lindy Infante, the head coach at Jacksonville.
Next to him, Charlie Davis, his assistant head coach, handles the offensive line. The other thing, too, is that they want to move that ball out far enough to give him an opportunity to kick it away in the event they don't pick up the first down. Otherwise, they're going to be susceptible with a shorter punt area to a potential block.
The lone setback is the fullback, number 24, Marvin Lewis. Third down and 6. Robinson from his own end zone airs it out. Overthrows his man, intended for number 80, Gary Clark. And so Jeff Pierce will come into the ball game to punt from his own end zone. Jacksonville in a hole when you've got to try and march 98 yards. Special teams are so important in a case like this.
Well, it figures in about 30% of the plays in the course of a football game. And right now, whether they choose to go for the block or because their offense is running like a well-oiled machine here this evening, is to go ahead and take the return because they're going to have excellent field position.
Jeff Pierce will kick from the back of his own end zone.
10-man rush.
They're coming. He gets off a beauty, backing Garcia Lane all the way back to his own 45-yard line. Takes it on the fly. And there's the reverse to Mark McCants. And look at that defensive play by number 89 for the Jacksonville Bulls. Alton Alexis was up there for a great stop. The razzle-dazzle try, but it got nowhere. We'll be back. A week from tonight, Jim Simpson and Don Heinrich will be in Los Angeles. See Arizona and L.A., a chance to see Steve Young, the talented young quarterback for the Express. That'll be a good one. Catch all the action right here on ESPN. Scott Fitzke, Tom Donovan, the wide receivers to the near side for Philadelphia as they put the ball in play. First and 10 from their own 45. Fusina over the middle to Donovan. They consider Donovan, number 87, the fellow, another Penn Stater, by the way, to have the best hands on the team.
He's been injured a little bit, bothered by a hamstring, but they were going to see prior to the game how good it felt, how effective he felt he could be, and certainly he's showing it right here as he's contributing. Fusina again down the middle, catches him in a zone, hits the open area, throws it in there.
You called that right all night, Don, about Fusina tending to pass on first down. He's already got the ball on the first play inside Jacksonville's 40-yard line. Willie Collier to the near side. Kitsky in motion to the far side. To give to Kelvin Bryant. He goes nowhere, changes direction, spins his way inside the 40, back to the 39, just to the line of scrimmage before he is stopped by Vaughn Johnson, number 33 for North Carolina State. And the laundry is down on the field.
Well, you know, Chuck Fusina, in his years at Penn State, they only lost two games in three regular seasons. And as the leader in the USFL, he has just gotten better and better. He's a technician. He probably has not gotten the recognition that he deserves. He's a very low-key kind of guy. Talking with him before the game, he says, I guess the best thing you could say about me is that I'm boring.
Block above the waist on the back. Number 89 on the offense. Replay first down.
Sometimes that's a benefit to you. You can catch your opponent by surprise. Oakland scored again. Quarterback Fred Fusina on a one-yard touchdown run, but they missed the point after. The Invaders leading the showboat 16-7 out on the West Coast. First and 20, the ball on the 49-yard line. Play action fake to Davld Riley. Fusina fakes once, pumps, rolls to the far side, and completes his pass to the big tight end, Steve Folsom, the big 89. He goes out of bounds across the 50 down near the 47-yard line, where he is pushed out by Kevin Gray, number 22, the cornerback for Jacksonville.
Excellent adjustment on the part of Fusina. And Folsom, as the flag is down deep in the secondary of the Bulls, they had a double screen faking initially out to the left. Fusina came back wanting to go to his tight end Folsom, but it was well covered by Zapala, the linebacker on the left side, number 57. Then he chose to make a decision to put the rush on Chuck, and Chuck Fusina quickly dumped it off to Folsom. Now we'll get a decision by the official.
The preliminary signal, as you take a look at Lindy Infante, is pass interference against Jacksonville.
Well, we saw him a couple of weeks ago against Tampa Bay. He felt that his club got some tough calls at the tail end of that football game.
Well, Lindy Infante must have some clout because the official, the referee, Tom White, changed the call, and the call now goes against Philadelphia. You know, the last time that Jim Mora and Lindy Infante faced each other on opposing sidelines, Mora was the defensive coordinator.
Pass interference, number 44 on the offense, also loss of down, second down.
That was Jim Mora on the sideline there for a moment with Jim Erkenbeck, his offensive coordinator.
Kelvin Bryant nailed for the call. As I was saying, the last time that Mora and Infante faced each other, Mora was the defensive coordinator for the Seattle Seahawks. Infante was in charge of the Super Bowl-bound Bengal offense, Cincinnati. That was an opening day in the NFL back in 1981. So these guys have played against each other before. Second down and 30. You've seen it to the air. For Davld Riley, and he drops the ball. Good coverage again by number 33, Vaughn Johnson. Johnson calls a lot of the defensive signals for what Lindy Infante says has to be a swarming defense. They've got to be all over the field because they know this Philadelphia team is just laden with talent.
They really are very deep for a second-year football team, and certainly they would like to improve in some of those areas. But Mora said that they have worked harder this year. They felt that not having won at all last year, that coming back to camp, they'd put more into it, that it has paid off.
Well, they came within a field goal of winning the league championship in the first season. Third down and 30, the ball resting on the 41 of Philadelphia. The pass complete to the far side of the field, number 81, Scott Fitzke. He skips his way down here to the 42-yard line before he is stopped by Kevin Gray. Jacksonville's defense spreading out and sort of the prevent. And the pass was complete on the far side of the field to Fitzke.
Good protection for Fitzke back there as he set up. Had plenty of time to look around. finally finding Fitzky down that right sideline, but just had too much real estate to try and negotiate.
Here's a look at Sean Landetta, the punter, and it's a fake. And look at this. The pass is complete to number 84, Herbert Harris. Davld Riley, number 35, threw that pass. Sean Landetta, number 7, was back in the punt formation. There was the short snap to the up man, the blocking back, number 35, Davld Riley. And O'Reilly sailed it downfield and found Herbert Harris going out of bounds for a first down inside the 20. They'll mark it at the 17-yard line.
Well, a little something out of the bag of tricks of Jim Mora. And Riley, we said he was versatile.
Here's a team leading 17-0, and Jim Mora is pulling out all the stops here with 4:35 to play in the first half.
The most underrated coach in professional football. All he does is win.
Throws over the middle and completes it to Kelvin Bryant, and he spins his way down inside the 5-yard line. Rush Brown, the nose tackle, number 69, in on the stop for the Bulls.
Bryant coming out of the backfield, a little trap-looking fake up the middle. Then as he just drifts downfield, once again, Fusina with excellent protection has time to look everywhere before he finally spots Fusina. I mean, Bryant, as he drifts upfield a little bit, and once more turning what appeared to be an incompleted pass upfield with great alertness on Fusina's part, gets him inside of the 5.
First and goal, the ball on the 4-yard line for Philadelphia, and Chuck Fusina calls timeout. 3:45 left to play in the first half, and Chuck Fusina apparently saw some sort of formation he did not like. They were trying to bring the two tight ends into the ballgame, Steve Folsom and Ken Dunnick, down inside the 4-yard line with a first and goal situation. There you see Fusina talking to the offensive coordinator, that is Jim Erkenbeck. He's the fellow that helps with this offensive strategy.
Jim, having been around a long time coaching-wise, used to coach out in the West Coast of California, spent some years up in Canada, moved into the offensive coordinator spots from his offensive line coaching position, and he's opened the attack up for him this season. They've been much more effective. You know, talking about Jim Mora too, Mike, we say all he does is win. You look at his record last year, this year, 14-1 at home over the last 2 years. I think it, you know, with 9 straight this season, you hear a lot of other coaches that get the recognition from the media people, but you can rest assured that Jim Mora's opponents week in and week out know where it's all going, and they don't like to face his team.
They know they've been in a football game. You know, as you say, they have something to prove. Last year, they came within 3 points of winning the national championship. They lost to Michigan in the championship game out in Denver, 24-22. They've won 9 in a row. If they win here tonight, that'll be a new USFL record, 10 straight.
And he feels that they can still get much better.
All right, first and goal, the ball resting on the 4-yard line. Davld Riley bangs his way down near the 3. Riley is getting an awful lot of action tonight. He was stopped in there by number 78, Brian Douglas, and number 99, Joe Costello, in this revamped, repaired Jacksonville Bull defense. Andy Hendel, Tom Dinkle, their two outstanding linebackers in the middle and on the outside, are out of action tonight. You know, at one time, Don, during the season, they have had 15 starters out of the lineup with injuries, this Jacksonville team. It's tough to play ball, especially when you're young, inexperienced, and an expansion team.
No question about it. It really is difficult.
Ball on the 2. Riley, touchdown, finally.
Gets his 5th touchdown of the season rushing on the ground. He's done about everything here this evening. He's blocked well. He's ran with the football. He's thrown passes from the fake punt. Finally scored that touchdown. Had to do it twice when they took the pass away from him for 6 points earlier from the end zone. Out in front of it, 44, Kelvin Bryant, 35, Davld Riley, the big fullback off the left side behind Brad Oates and George Gilbert.
To the left of your screen, number 10, the backup quarterback, Tim Reardon. He is the holder. Davld Trout, the kicker. And he's splits the uprights. A good view from our end zone overhead camera. Davld Riley, two touchdowns rushing tonight. He caught a touchdown pass that was called back when Brad Oates got nailed for holding. But with 3:04 left to play in the first half, Philadelphia is running away with a score of 24-0. Well, put yourself in the shoes of Lindy Infante. You're down 24-0. You'd like to get a score here before you go into the locker room, just to get a little morale, a little momentum going, a little confidence builder.
Well, he's down, has his kickoff return unit crowded around him. He wants to get decent field position. There goes Lindy walking up the sidelines, and that's a tough spot to be in. You're down this quick at the halftime, going towards the half with a little over 3 minutes, 24-0. The scoring drive, 54 yards in 8 plays, 2-yard run by Riley, took up 3 minutes and 36 seconds. And that's one thing about this Philadelphia Star team. They can pound you on the ground, eat up that clock, or they can score quick through the air.
Well, it's not like it's a surprise, because in the last 5 games, the Stars have outscored their opponents by 111 points.
Oh, they're really a well-balanced football team.
Trout puts the toe to the leather. Aubrey Matthews, deep in his own end zone, muffs it out of the end zone. So the Jacksonville Bulls, with under 3 minutes to play here in the first half in Veterans Stadium, Philadelphia, will put the ball in play, first and 10 from their own 20-yard line. It's a first down and 10. The ball on the 24. Matt Robinson in charge, the trigger man of Lindy Infante's high-powered Jacksonville offense. The little flare pass intended for Larry Mason, batted down by number 91, Buddy Moore. Second and 10, ball remaining on the 23-yard line. The lone setback is Mason. He steps up tight. He stops the blitz. Robinson, their quick opener right over the middle on the inside slant to Gary Clark. And they have the ball inside the 20 down near the 18-yard. First and goal. 1:46 left to play. Over the middle. Second down. Larry Mason, the lone setback. Robinson to the far side. He has number 80, Gary Clark, and he fights down near the 1 yard line before he is ridden out of bounds by number 47. First and goal from the one. They work in the I formation. Lewis in motion. Larry Mason, touchdown. Nobody near him. Running behind Bob Gruber and Kenny Howell. Larry Mason is in the end zone, and you don't see him spike the ball. He's just taking a breather and saying, finally. The extra point attempt, Jeff Pierce to hold, Brian Franco. Oh, and they muff the snap. Pierce picks it up and tries to run. Of course, in the United States football, you can get a two-point conversion. But what a bummer. What a downer that has to be. After you march the length of the football field, a nice drive, call your timeouts, collect your senses, get the ball in the end zone, and then you miss the extra point.
Well, the snap is pretty good. It's just getting it down is wrong. Threw it out of sync as far as the kicker's concerned. But you mentioned special teams a little bit earlier. And, of course, the return teams have hurt them. And now to go for the extra point, they managed to blow that one as Brian Franco can't time it, and unfortunately they settle for just 6 points. And that tells you right there, Lindy Infante walking away, shaking his head, hands on hips, saying, wait a minute. And the special teams coaches meantime slip to the other end of the bench. And I'll tell you what, I think if I were him, I'd call a few of those people together, and you can bet that Lindy Infante will have a few things to say at the halftime about the special teams.
24-6 is our score. They mounted a pretty good drive on that play.
Excellent drive. Best drive of the evening as far as they're concerned. 80 yards, 8 plays. Didn't take long. 1:30 with Mason's 1 yard run into the end zone.
When Matt Robinson had to, he marched him right down the field. You talk about the dominance of the Philadelphia Stars, who have the best record in the league of 11-1 coming into tonight's action. In the last 6 games, they have outscored their opponents in the first half 135-12. Mark McCants from his own 6-yard line follows the wedge of blockers, still on his feet, diving up across the 35-yard line before he is hit by number 50, John McClain. Mark McCants is a player special teams. 1:26 to play in the first half. Chuck Fusina, the quarterback, coming out now for Philadelphia.
You look through that face mask, if he isn't a pretty close lookalike to Tom Selleck, I don't know who is. I'll tell you, he's a nice young man, talking with him before the game.
Chuck Fusina, his wife Jackie, expecting their first child in October. He's got a birthday coming up the end of this month. That's where to celebrate it. If they win tonight, it'll be 10 in a row, a new USFL record. Chuck to the air, the short, quick opener over the middle. Allen Harvin. He spins his way up across the 45-yard line before Fernando Jackson knocks him down.
You might wonder if they'd sit on it. They've gone to their two-minute drill. They are not going to. Decent field position. Minute and 20 seconds roughly to go. They're putting it in the air. They want more points.
I think Fusina's thrown on first down every first down tonight.
It's kept them off balance, no question about it.
They're in the pro set. He sends Harvin out of the backfield, throws over the middle. Intended for Willie Collier, number 86. Willie was down. He had slipped when he stopped on the little curl back there, the little comebacker. Couldn't catch up with the football. Stars have one timeout left.
Despite that rain earlier today, as Jim Mora looks on, the field was not slick when we were down there. They're just having a little trouble with their footing. We've seen several slips by players in all of the positions.
It's turned out to be a pleasant evening. The sun came out at mid-afternoon. It's a little muggy. It was 74 degrees at game time. The humidity about 66%. But it's pleasant tonight now as the Stars from the pro set face a 3rd and 10. Fusina says, I'll run it right up the middle. Look at him go. And he's safe at home with a Rod Carew hook slide at home plate before he is stopped by Sammy Brown.
Sammy Brown giving him a little necktie tackle, but Fusina knew where it was, got to the ground, got underneath it, Brown going over the top of him a little.
Boy, they want more. They lead in the ballgame 24-6. Fusina doing a little traffic directing in the backfield. They go with no huddle. They stop the clock temporarily to move the chains on the first down as the give goes to Kelvin Bryant.
High roll up.
And the clock is stopped with 49 seconds to play here in the first half. Vaughn Johnson in on the stop of Kelvin Bryant, who picks himself off the tartan turf here at Veterans Stadium. Coming up on Monday night here on ESPN, the Pittsburgh Maulers and the New Jersey Generals, a chance to see a couple of Heisman runners. Mike Rozier, Herschel Walker, Jim Simpson, and Paul McGuire will be there from Giants Stadium in the Meadowlands. New Jersey pretty much on the roll. They'll need a victory there on Monday night, the Generals will, to keep pace with Philadelphia. Right now, the Stars lead by a full 2 games in the Atlantic Division. That was the final timeout here in the first half for Philadelphia. I guess they'd like to get another score on that board.
Well, at least an attempt at a field goal if they get within range, but Chuck Fusina using that timeout at that stage. He's been the major factor, although there have been several considerations that Jim Mora mentioned with this club, but particularly in Fusina's behalf, where he's playing with so much more confidence, less conservative, more deep routes that have opened things up underneath, a lot of poise out there. He's just the quiet, effective leader.
Second down and 9. The ball on the Bulls' 38-yard line. Fusina. Aiming for number 84, Herbert Harris bounced it low in front of him. Harris, another guy, along with Mark McCants, who are just superb players on the special teams. Harris getting quite a bit of action in a wide receiver tonight.
He is. It's as much playing time as he's gotten offensively this season. And Fusina was unhappy with himself that time, trying to let it go quick when Harris was open there for a moment and just threw it a little bit low.
You were talking before about Chuck Fusina and the fact that he's not really a flamboyant guy. You know, he's not going to be doing any underwear ads or anything like that. But he is a solid guy. He does everything he can to win. as he completes a pass here to number 81, Scott Fitzke. A lot of people may forget, back in 1978, Chuck Fusina was runner-up to Billy Sims for the Heisman Trophy.
I know it. He was second, and of course, drafted by Tampa Bay. He got behind Big Doug Williams, never had an opportunity to play as he sat on the bench, had a short turn with the 49ers, was there for a week or two when they had some injury problems, and consequently, a year ago is almost like his rookie year. Even though he had been exposed to the game and spent all the time, it's not the same. You get better by doing, you've got to play, and he has just continued to get better. He threw 15 touchdown passes in 83. He had 24 coming into tonight, so you can see his production has been significantly better, but his overall game has just become very, very solid. As Jim Moore kind of smiling, he's happy at the moment, but he still wants more points.
Jacksonville with a timeout here. They have one remaining with 41 seconds to play in the first half. 24-6 the score. Stars on top. Memphis, the Showboats, back in the ballgame. They are in the third quarter of that one. They trail by two to the Oakland Invaders. I think one of the reasons Fusina has really come on strong this year was when Kelvin Bryant went out of the lineup with the injury. And he was hurting much of the time. Instead of just handing off to Bryant all the time, this gave Chuck a chance to show how he could throw the football. And I know he wants to be involved in every play. Bryant and Harvin are the split backs. First and 10, the ball on the 27-yard line. Collier in motion. Fusina to put it up. Goes over the middle to Kelvin Bryant. Another low pass. Bryant probably could have caught it, but it looked like Fusina was hit just as he threw the football.
And I'll tell you, had Kelvin Bryant caught it, there was nobody there. They blew the coverage. They chose to blitz. They did not pick up Bryant. You'll see him out of the backfield, just at the tail end. That's Harvin stepping up to make a block. Fusina a little bit low, but there is no one behind him. Had he had time, he not only had him down the middle for a walk-in touchdown, but he had Tom Donovan split out to the left side, who was in great position. Donald Dykes, the corner over there. I would expect Fusina might go back to work on him. Had a man for man.
Second and 10 now. Fusina's going to run it. He's inside the 20. He's down to the 10-yard line before he slides to the turf. Stopped by number 46, Don Besselou, and number 47, Sammy Brown. 28 seconds to play here in the first half, and Philadelphia's going for it.
Well, the protection is good initially. A little pressure from the inside, but nothing to amount to anything. And Fusina sees it open up and just takes off downfield, trying to get to the sidelines. He recognizes that Besselou's coming. They're ready to go.
Fusina rolling to his right, looking in the end zone. Runs and gets out of bounds down near the 8-yard line, chased for his life by Vaughn Johnson, number 33. We've received word from the sidelines, Don, that Davld Riley, who has two touchdowns in the ballgame already, will not return. He's out with a pinched nerve, I believe, in his neck, and he won't see any more action.
That would probably bring in Jeff Rodenberger to replace him. Good move by Fusina there. You know, that's one of the tough things for a quarterback. People figure, well, you're in shape, shouldn't be any problem. Here he's run two in a row, the first one longer than this one, but he ran a lot of yards to pick up what he did. And as a result, he comes back. He's got to call the plays the next time, or if they line right up at the line of scrimmage, it
personal
clock
foul,
stop.
Unnecessary roughness. Late hit out of bounds. Number 33 on the defense. First down.
Well, Vaughn Johnson, the linebacker, rookie linebacker, a little frustrated as he hits Fusina going out of bounds late. So that stopped the clock. But Fusina, you know, when you get up there, you're gasping for breath. You're trying to get the call out. Hard to do sometimes.
Sounds like first-hand information from the old quarterback, Don Heinrich. Starred for years with the Giants. Fusina, in the end zone, drills it into the arms of number 84, Herbert Harris. And that is good for the touchdown. And old Herbert Harris does the duck shuffle.
Nice grab by Harris. The flag is going up. We got a fight on the field. As Kelvin Bryant is into it on the far side with somebody. Couldn't pick up the number over there. Bryant had him pinned to the ground. Looked like a full fall. Whoever was underneath was extremely unhappy. Little battle going.
Touchdown is good. We got got a personal foul, unnecessary roughness, number 23 on the defense, personal foul, unnecessary roughness, 44 on the offense, the penalty's all set.
Gosh, Kelvin Bryant, a generally mild-mannered kind of a person.
And Donald Dykes.
And Donald Dykes, a defensive corner, getting into it. Well, at least he didn't pick on one of those big linemen. Well, the Stars have scored on all five possessions. As Fusina going back, once again, excellent protection, good field of vision, down the middle. Oh, Tom Donovan says, I like it.
That was a nice catch by Harris. That pass was short about 10 yards. And Fusina looked like he really drilled it in there.
He did, rifled it.
The extra point is tacked on by David Trout. And suddenly it's a 31-6 ball game with 10 seconds left here in the first half of play.
Harris coming from the left side of the screen. Good follow through, good zip on the football. And unfortunately, the duck shuffle means 6 points for the Stars. He says, yeah, that's what I like.
A little excitement from the Fed here. Well, I want to hear more about this, Don, about quarterbacks not wanting to run and being out of breath and all that.
Well,
did you like to run when you played? Or?
Well, you know, I don't think too many of them like to run unless they absolutely have to. They may say that they like it. Most of the time, it's self-preservation or from fright. Some of them can run better than others, obviously. They have some good quickness, but it generally doesn't take them long to find out that they better get out of bounds or they better get to the ground. They pay those other two guys back there to do that.
Here's a look at Herbert Harris. He scored the touchdown.
It's his second touchdown of the year. 64 yards, 10 plays, didn't take long, 124. Four-yarder, Fusina to Harris.
Chuck Fusina's second touchdown pass of the night back in the first quarter. He hit the Penn Stater, Scott Pitsky. Trout boots it deep into the end zone. Aubrey Matthews was on it.
Better get some glue for Aubrey. He's dropped three of them back there, even though the last two he wouldn't have been able to run out, but still in all, you expect him to hang on to it, put a handle on it.
A total of 10 penalties have been called between both teams in the first half. I guess they're both going to go at it.
Well, the Stars an aggressive ball club both ways, offensive and defensively. On the other hand, the Bulls frustrated early in the year. They lost some close football games that they conceivably could or should have won. Now they're in a bit of a tailspin, and they're fighting for their life out there.
You hear Matt Robinson barking out the signals. He gives it right up the middle of Larry Mason, basically running out the clock, although he gained some good yardage on it. 3 seconds left to play here in the first half. Clock stops momentarily as they move the chains for the first down, but it looks like Jacksonville is merely going to run it out here. Thought maybe we'd see Robinson air it out. Hail Mary with three guys flooding a zone or something like that. They trail in the ballgame, 31-6. And there is the gun, signaling the end of the first half. So Lindy Infante trailing in the ballgame, 31-6. Jim Mora, he's enjoying this ballgame. Infante's got his work cut out for them. As you see the look of consternation on the face of the man on the left. Philadelphia with the ball now. The handoff goes to Bryant as they put the ball in play on the 50-yard line. He is down to the 45. Bryant came into the ball game as the second leading rusher in the league with 838 yards so far. He picked up 17 in the first half.
Going from that up position, gets the handoff, veers back to the inside, gets some blocking. They go to Irv Eatman, the big tackle, right side there. And the right guard, Chuck Comiskey, one 280, the other 290. Nice twosome to run behind.
We're talking about Irv Eatman and what a fine All-American player he is at 6'6". In practice this week, the raw, talented kid, Mike McGinnis, knocked Eatman down about six times. Look at this. Number 99, Joe Costello in there on the stop.
Eatman says he likes to work against McGinnis because it gives him a real test every time out, every play. He just like a buzzsaw.
That's one of the problems when somebody is as talented as an Irv Eatman, Don, is you lose your concentration if nobody's challenging you.
Well, he said it keeps him from getting complacent as well. And then, of course, he's subject to the barbs of his teammates as he's been dropped periodically on his wallet.
Well, they say this Mike McGinnis is just almost in the daze because he's been on the developmental all this time, and now he is playing in his first professional football game tonight. Fusina on third down. The little out pass to Alan Harlan tries to get up but cannot. Dragged down by Kevin Gray, the cornerback, number 22 out of Eastern Illinois.
Excellent job by Fusina as Harvard comes over, gets open. Eatman, 75. You see him get the hands up. You see him just controlling. Bob Clasby, number 98, takes care of him, says try that, and there's just a little extra.
First down, the ball on the Bulls' 38-yard line. Kelvin Bryant, the lone setback. Collier to the near side. The pitch goes to Bryant. He sweeps right behind Irv Eatman and Chuck Comiskey. Just about fights his way back to the line of scrimmage.
You know, Mike.
There's Kevin Gray, the cornerback, being tended to on the Jacksonville sideline. He was on that previous play.
I was just about to say that there's Gray. That was to the side. The play was run. Can you imagine Eatman, the tackle, Comiskey, the guard, at 290 and 280 coming out there? And you're a little cornerback. That's got to get you thinking a little bit.
The Oakland Invaders still clinging to a two-point lead over Memphis there in the fourth quarter in that ball game out west. Here it's 31-6 with 9:33 to play, third quarter. Fusina lofting the ball down the middle. Kelvin Bryant has it inside the 15-yard line. Don Besselou in on the stop, number 46, and Bryant, a nice job, a nice soft touch there by Fusina.
Well, Bryant coming out of the backfield, he's on the right side of the screen. That play action move again, they pull a guard, that influences him. He's run what you call a seam pattern, just outside the tight end, down the middle, high in the air to make the catch as Besselou comes over to corral him on it, but not until it was a big gain inside the 15-yard line.
Good concentration by Kelvin Bryant, who is now on the sidelines for a breather on that play.
Very good. He had 32 receptions going in. He's had several this evening. Good hands, good concentration.
Jeff Rodenberger and Alan Harvin in the backfield, and Harvin gets the call. Fights his way up near the 15-yard line for a loss on a play of perhaps one. John McLean, 6'3", 220, a rookie out of Florida State, number 50, in on the stop. Loss of a yard on the play. Second down, 11, the ball on the 15-yard line.
Well, when you get something working for you, despite not getting anything out of that sweep, you generally stay with it, and their sweeps have been affected this evening.
Willie Collier to the near side. Donovan to the far side. Fusina checks off. He's only got 3 seconds left, and he just barely gets the play off. Plenty of time. Rifles in the end zone. And coming up to make the catch is number 81, Scott Pitsky. And there is a flag on the play back here where Chuck Fusina released the football.
Well, there was no doubt Fusina was going to the automatic pass. They being the Bulls, showing blitz, had everybody up there. Don Besselou had snuck up, looked like it was going to be a safety blitz. Jim Mora waiting for the call. But as he switched off, they changed.
7:50 to play, third quarter. 31-6, Philadelphia with the lead and the football on a second down and 26. And it's complete to Tommy Donovan, but he juggled the ball. I'm not sure whether they'll call it. No, they do call it incomplete. Fusina runs up, thought he had it.
He felt he had the possession.
It almost looked like he lost possession of the football when he went down and hit the turf, which would make it a muff.
Going
would
down,
be a legal catch.
Going down low to his knees there. Well, it looked like he had the ball caught, and then really just kind of got away from him for a moment. I was out at the halftime talking to Connie Moore, Jim Moore's wife. I asked her when they had such a substantial lead, is she the power behind the force, give her all the best plays? She said, well, just tell him to remember me and Jim in Seattle and our family. Big fans out there in Seattle. Great coach of the Seahawks. Great job for Don James at the University of Washington. Great job here.
Big third down play for the Stars. Fusina being chased back there by Mike Johnson. Now he's running for his life. A good chop block there by Bart Oates. And he completes the pass inside the 15-yard line. Rush Brown was also chasing him. And he nailed him back there.
Boy, when you said a nice cut block by Bart Oates, he came peeling back to spring Fusina loose for a moment, get him out of the grasp of a defender as the flag was going down. Now somebody throws a smoke bomb on the field. We're in Philadelphia, folks, city of brotherly love.
The infraction probably against the nose tackle for Jacksonville, number 69, Russ Brown. There you see him at the left of your screen as Tom White, the referee, walks over to march it off. Looked like he elbowed Chuck Fusina in the backfield. It will probably be a roughing the passer call.
Nice crowd on hand here this evening. You know, you look at the Bulls, they lead the league as far
personal
as...
Personal foul, roughing the passer, number 69 on the defense.
Coming in at mistakes they couldn't have and still win the ball game. And that was a costly one there because the Stars have it first and goal from the 6-yard line. Bryant hops his way over one defender inside the 5 down to the 3-yard line. Greg Sapala in on the stop.
Nice move by Bryant going in there. There wasn't any hole. They kind of submarine clogged it up. Watch him high step over the top right here. Bryant, watch you see his feet come up right there, break through there. Gives him that extra forward momentum and leverage in case there are any tackles to break. But an adjustment on his part, which he does so very, very well.
They mark the ball at the 2-yard line. Second and goal from there. They operate out of the I formation. Hurdles his way into the end zone for a touchdown. Bart Oates and Chuck Comiskey leading the way.
Essentially the same kind of move on his part as he kind of high-stepped over the top. That's why he was MVP a year ago. Great move. Two times in a row he uses right here. See him go up over the top. Now a lot of guys will dive for that end zone. In this instance, his adjustment was just to reach up. Comiskey and Eaton. The right tackle, right guard. Look at him move back that defensive unit. A little adjustment by Bryant. 6 points.
David Trout to attempt the point after. And he sneaks it through. 38-6, our score. There's the man of the hour, Kelvin Bryant. 17 yards rushing in the first half. Comes back here in the third quarter to score a big touchdown. Jacksonville trails in this ballgame by 32. Back at Veterans Stadium in Philadelphia, 6:42 to play, third quarter. Philadelphia having it all their way, leading the Jacksonville Bulls 38-6. To the left of your screen is Larry Key. To the right of your screen was Perry Kemp. This is David Trout, set to kick off from his own 35-yard line. The little guy's been hammering them into the end zone all night. And the ball mysteriously blows off the tee one more time. Trout, you know, kickers are superstitious. I think he's talking to it.
Scoring drive, 50 yards, 10 plays. Once again, pretty time-consuming. 5:22. Bryant taking it over. Two consecutive plays off the right side. 2 yards for the touchdown.
Larry Key, Florida State man. He's going to run it out from about 2 yards deep. And he is clotheslined at about the 12 and rolls his way up near the 15-yard line. McCants, number 20, the special teams man. You see him there for the Philadelphia Stars. McCants, ironically, the man who runs back kicks for the Stars. Here in on the defending special team. They were expecting in the neighborhood of about 30,000 here tonight for this Saturday night contest. First and 10 from the 15. Little outlet pass in the near flat to the tight end, Paul Bergman. And he fights his way up near the 23. Not much time left.
And they're going to blitz again. They're all up there.
Wyatt Henderson in the ball game. To the near side. Robinson puts it up. The ball intended to, for number 82. This kicking situation, Jeff Pierce. We'll see if there's any razzle-dazzle or a fake on this play because Jacksonville's got to get back in the ballgame. Pierce is going to boot it. Garcia Lane back at his own 32-yard line. Goes to the far side, finds no room, skips his way up across the 35 up near the 36-yard line before he is snowed under by a wall of red jerseys. Chris Wampler in on the stop, number 77. So the Philadelphia Stars leading 38-6 will put the ball in play, first and 10 from their own 36-yard line. There was a flag on the play, and we'll see what the referee. Apparently an interference call there against Philadelphia.
When you get so often, it appears as though it's pushing on the Stars.
The most points the Philadelphia Stars have scored in their history, 43. That against the Birmingham Stallions earlier this year.
Illegal block, above the waist in the back, number 36 during the return. First down. Timeout.
5 minutes to play here in the third quarter. We'll be back. The code word for the month of May is Red Dog. For those of you who have not begun to play, stay tuned to ESPN to find out how you can win valuable prizes just by watching the USFL right here on ESPN. Bryant, the ball carrier, across the 30. He's got room across the 35, and a flag is down as Bryant is wrestled to the turf by number 46, Don Besselou, up near the 36-yard line.
Good blocking initially on the sweep coming around there. They were rolling into a double zone on the outside. Kevin Gray, the corner, was up. Weak side safety. Besselou had dropped back, put him right into the pattern of where Bryant was running the football, but not until after he had picked up some good yardage, and we get the call from the official here in just a moment.
The crowd might wrestle us here, and I don't know why, because most of these partisan fans are rooting for Philadelphia, and they're certainly in the driver's
personal
seat.
Foul. Intentional grabbing of the face mask, 35 on the defense, first down.
That was John Lott, a rookie. He'd been starting some games on corner for the Bulls earlier, but then lost his job, now back in.
It's another mistake for Jacksonville and a costly one, but I guess you can understand it. They're quite unhappy to be trailing in this ball game with a lopsided margin. Fusina. He's got room. He's chased, and he's finally dragged down from behind by number 98, Bob Claspy, the left end. You know, it's got to be frustration more than anything. Jacksonville is an expansion team. They're a very young ball club, not a whole lot of veterans, and it's got to be just frustrating for them out there.
No doubt that they are, coupled with the injuries, coupled with early season losses. Everybody gets injuries. Certainly Lindy, you see on the sidelines there, is frustrated as he turns to Charlie Davis.
Second and 12, the ball on the Jacksonville 49-yard line. They go with one setback, that's Kelvin Bryant. And the flag is up. Apparently an unsportsmanlike conduct call. This will be interesting. We didn't see any movement or any fighting, but somebody might have said something to someone else. They mark this off against the Philadelphia Stars.
I'll tell you, they always say something to someone else when they're down on the field. There's a lot of talk goes on.
Unsportsmanlike conduct, lingering on the offense, second down.
Lingering on the offense. They said they were moving too slow. They still had 3 seconds on the 30-second clock. Bryant kind of smiling there. Don't know whether he had anything to do with it or not, but Jim Mora looking on. I'll tell you, what a class guy. He doesn't want to see anything out of character despite whatever penalties are being called. He wants people to give them full effort, great intensity. A fine gentleman himself, terrific family, great coach.
Now they march it down the other way against Jacksonville. Back to the 49-yard line. Let's listen to the referee, Tom White, for an explanation. It's second down. Lindy Infante agreeing with us. What's going on here?
Might have said a little more than that to that official.
They work out of the pro set here with 4 minutes, 21 seconds to play, third quarter. And Fusina's going to the air again. Bryant. Down near the 43-yard line before he's wrestled down, hogtied by Fernando Jackson of Florida.
Kelvin
Ryan, coming out of the backfield to the right of the screen, runs like a circle and then a flat move, hooks it up. Fusina lays it out there, perfect to him. Fernando Jackson, excellent speed, number 53. Good blitzer, has several interceptions for the year. Good quickness for a linebacker. Was a starter, lost his job, now back in due to injuries.
Third and five, the ball on the 42. The left side, they clear it out, and the pass is complete to number 89, Steve Folsom, the big tight end. 84, Herbert Harris, and 87, Tommy Donovan, clearing out that left side, opening it up underneath the linebackers for Paul Bergman, or for Steve Folsom.
Folsom took just an inside release there, came off clean, no holdup, ran shallow, gained a little bit of ground as he was coming from right to left. They were in a man-for-man coverage, strong safety, Sammy Brown was responsible, was behind him, Fusina hit him.
First down, 10 to go, ball on the 32. They work out of the eye. The first man through on the quick hitter is Alvin Harmon. Across the 30, down near the 28 before he is racked up by John McLean. 2:49 to play here, third quarter. The Stars driving toward another score, perhaps, and if they get it, it could be their highest output of the year. Earlier this year, they beat the Birmingham Stallions 43-11. That was their previous high score of the year, 43 points. They've got 38 already here in the third quarter. They shift into the eye, the deep man, the tailback is Bryant. Houston on the fake, throws over the middle to number 89, Steve Folsom. Folsom wrestles his way into the end zone, touchdown Philadelphia. And Folsom is hurt.
What great second effort on Folsom's part. Irv Eatman ran down there, took the ball away from him and spiked it. But Folsom's down on the ground directly in front of the goalpost. He was running a seam pattern, caught him in a zone, took some shots from Sammy Brown, the strong safety. Don Vesalou, the weak safety. Play action fake. Fusina laying it over the top as Folsom comes down. Pow! He takes it in there from both sides. Fight stays on his feet. Oh, that's the kind of playing you like to see by a guy. Keep going. Get the 6 points. Of course, you don't want to see him hurt.
It was difficult to see on the replay just where he was injured, unless he had the wind knocked out of him, perhaps when he rolled on the football.
Well, he took that double shot from both sides. It's hard to say, but he certainly had presence of mind to take it on the end zone, take it on in. Good second effort on his part. Just more than anything, appears to be shook up.
He's a big target at 6'4", 230, a four-year man.
Just up over the hands, outstretched arms of Vaughn Johnson, 33. Right there where he takes the hit, even though he's hurt. Good second effort. They're trying to wrap around. Vesalou getting one arm in, but Folsom smells that pay dirt. He's going to take it on in. He's had four touchdowns coming into this thing, and he wanted another.
Sandwich City, and Folsom turns it into six as Trout tacks on the extra point. And the Philadelphia Stars have jumped on top of Jacksonville 45-6. That is the highest output so far this year. And the Stars leading by 33. It's a safe bet they'll up their record to 12-1, the best record in the USFL. And you see the New Jersey Generals will drop 2.5 games behind, putting them in a must-win situation against Pittsburgh here on ESPN with Jim Simpson and Paul McGuire on Monday night. Philadelphia from here on out down, they go to Michigan for a tough ball game.
Well, they've got Pittsburgh that's been in a bit of a slump, but they're playing so well right now, I don't think it matters too much who they go up against.
And the final game of the season, Philadelphia will host New Jersey here at the Met. That should be a good one. Brian Thomas in the ballgame for Philadelphia at running back now. A 5'10", 191-pound first-year man out of Pittsburgh. Carrying the ball on the play and stopped by Doug West.
Well, early in the year, the Stars were having some problems in the turnover areas. Jim Morris said, we'll get that thing straightened out. They came into this game with 13 fumbles. They only fumbled 17 times in 18 games a year ago. But since that time, they have created turnovers and, in essence, not had many of their own.
Trap!
We're seeing a good, solid football team in Philadelphia. They'll be in the playoffs for certain. And they're thinking league title. Rodenberger, the ball carrier, kid out of Maryland. to Brian Thomas. Works his way up near a first down. John McLean. Take a look at Kelvin Bryant. 121 total yards tonight, 73 yards rushing.
Thought he had over 100. Bulls took a lot of looks at him.
He's over 900 yards rushing for the year now. Thomas, the ball carrier, gets plenty of room around that left side. Chris Wampler in on the stop, number 77, the kid out of Tennessee. The Stars leading Jacksonville 45-12. Arizona now has jumped off to a 21-0 lead over Denver in the second quarter out of Tempe. Landry going 15 yards to Lenny Willis for the touchdown, 21-0. Earlier, Oakland beat Memphis 29-14. Second down and two, the ball on the 36-yard line. Tim Reardon is in at quarterback, replacing Chuck Fusina. Jeff Rodenberger, the ball carrier, and he fights his way up across the 40-yard line. Leading by such a bulge here, Don, we're seeing people like Tim Reardon at quarterback, Jeff Rodenberger and Brian Thomas at running back. A lot of people that normally don't get in the ball game should it be close.
From a coach's standpoint, it gives you that opportunity to play those younger people. When you have that big lead, you can afford to let them get out there, get a little bit of experience, get a little taste. Contact. They haven't had any since training camp because none of the pro teams will have any kind of scrimmages during the season. Do some bumping, but not all out goes.
On the first down, Brian Thomas gets to call, sweeps to the top of your screen, and there is a flag. Field balls, throw balls, score touchdowns. He had a good evening before he left the ball game with pain. Thomas on the misdirection, sweeps left. Is a wrestle out of bounds by number 50. They want it so bad they can taste it this year. And they're well on their way as Rodenberger goes right up the gut. Chris Wampler in on the stop. Chuck Fusina, what a night. Three touchdown passes, 302 yards passing. He has really been kind of reborn here in the USFL. Last year kind of feeling his way, good and solid. This year he has come on like a house of fire.
Three games earlier this season.
The final gun sounds, putting Jacksonville out of its misery as Jim Moore is happy, winning 10 in a row, a league record, our final, 45-12. For Don Heinrich, this is Mike Barry. So long.